Hi, my name is Cole from FC Piero, and today I'm going to show you how to replace your spark plugs and ignition coils on your Mk8 Golf R and GTI. Yeah, let's replace those. In front of me, I have the APR ignition coil and spark plug service kit. This kit includes the APR Iridium Pro spark plugs, the APR ignition coils, and a tube of dielectric grease. So the APR ignition service kit is going to give us 10% more output on the ignition coils, and we're going to be running a heat range 9 spark plug. Now that colder step of the spark plug is going to allow the ignition system to run cooler, because we are going to be putting some more power in this car in some later DIY videos. So we're going to take that step now while we're here. If you're looking for some non-performance options for your Golf R, we offer genuine OEM and OE for your vehicle. So rest assured, if you're going from stock to wild, we have the options for you. So some key symptoms to indicate if your ignition systems need some servicing will be a poor rough start, idling issues, misfires, and overall poor performance with fuel economy and acceleration. Those are some things that you're going to have to look out for, and it might be some indication to take a look at your vehicle. Now, Volkswagen recommends replacing these spark plugs every 40,000 miles and 4 years, but here at FCP Euro, we recommend replacing the spark plugs at every 30,000 miles. As far as ignition coils go, there is not a recommended service interval from Volkswagen. However, FCP Euro, we recommend replacing the ignition coils every 100,000 miles or when the ignition coil has failed. Servicing your ignition system may feel daunting, but it's quite simple. So I'm going to show you all the tools that you're going to need to replace your ignition coils and spark plugs. We're going to need a 10 millimeter socket, 10 millimeter thin wrench, ratchet, a 5/8 or 16 millimeter spark plug socket, spark plug gapper tool. Electric ratchets, while not needed, will help speed things up. We're gonna need a torque wrench with a range of 10 to 30 newton meters. A 90 degree pick, a CTA 7390 ignition coil removal tool that you can find at fcpeuro.com, and a air chuck, which is not necessarily needed, but I'm gonna show you later in this DIY video how this can come into play. Now that we've gone over all the tools, let's get started on this DIY. All right, so we are underneath the hood now, and the first step is going to be removing the engine cover. We don't have one on our Mk8 Golf R due to a recall performed by Volkswagen, so that's a step that we're not doing right now, but there are 4 little dowels here that have some rubber grommets, so that engine cover just pops right off. Now, after the engine cover is removed, I am going to be loosening these nuts on the ignition coil hold downs, which also holds down the ground wires on the ignition coils. So I'm gonna need a 10 millimeter, very thin wrench that will slide underneath of it. And then I'm gonna take my 10 millimeter socket, and while counter holding with my right hand, I'm gonna loosen with my left and remove that nut. Now I'm going to do that to all 4 underneath the engine bay, and then move to removing the actual hold down bolts below it. Once I have all of those 4 nuts removed, I'm going to take this ground strap off and move it to the side out of the way. This middle one, it's good to use your right hand and move that wiring harness off to the right a little bit, like so. Perfect. Now I'm gonna take my 10 millimeter socket and remove the remainder of the coil pack hold down bolt. Now I'm gonna remove all the electric connectors from the coil pack. With this vehicle, since it's quite new, I can just push up on the tab and release up. On some older vehicles, it's nice to have a little 90 degree pick and get right underneath the tab, pry it up slightly to break that seal, and we can continue to move them upwards like so. Now we're gonna have to move this harness a little bit out of the way, and I like to push downward and kind of get them underneath the or to the side of the ignition coils themselves. Once this is loose, you can see I can move this all around like so when I'm gonna be removing my ignition coils. Now there's two ways that you can remove these ignition coils. One, you can use the tool that Volkswagen made for removing these types of ignition coils that you can find on our website, or you can use brunt force, pull directly upwards and pull it out. However, as you can see, my boot on this one has come undone, which I have a special trick for you to show you how to get those boots out without damaging them. Now, normally people would try to use a pair of pliers and grab it and pull it upwards like that. However, you can damage the boot. So what we're gonna do is take some compressed air and blow a little bit down the center of the hole. And that is going to break the seal of the rubber against the plug and help us remove this piece if it separates. Now, the separation of the ignition coil boot and the ignition coil is not something that's gonna happen all the time. But if it does separate, for example, on a higher mileage vehicle where it may have a little bit more heat cycles in it, that's the proper way to do it. Now, we showed you how to remove the ignition coil with just using your hands. However, they do make a special tool for this style of ignition coil that makes it a lot easier to grab that. So I'm going to take this tool and I'm going to insert it into the hole just like so. Then I'm going to tighten the threaded nut until I get a really positive engagement and it cannot tighten anymore. Now I'm gonna wrap my hands around the little indents here and pull directly upwards, just like so. Now I'm going to repeat the process and removing all the rest of the ignition coils. As you can see, they have a little bit of resistance when I'm pulling these all out. So don't be afraid if you have to tug a little bit hard to break that seal from the rubber and the spark plug. Now that we have all of the ignition coils removed, it's good practice to blow out all the area around the spark plug hole openings, just because when we remove those spark plugs, we don't want any debris to enter the engine. Now that I have all of my ignition coils removed, I'm gonna use a 5/8 of an inch or 16 millimeter spark plug socket to break these free. This is gonna be a 3/8 drive on my end, so I'm gonna use my ratchet, break it free, and then loosen it all the way. Now, when removing these spark plugs, I'm gonna be assessing the condition of the spark plug electrode because it can tell you a lot about how your engine is running. If it is black, that means it can be running a little bit rich. And if it's white, that means it can be running lean. Now, this color of the spark plug looks pretty uniform, which is to expect, so our engine is running very nicely. Now I'm gonna take my socket and remove all the spark plugs and get our new spark plugs prepped for installation. Now that we have all of our old spark plugs removed, we're gonna be checking the spark plug electrode gap on our new APR plugs. Now I'm gonna be using a spark plug electrode gap tool in the shape of a coin. This is a very common tool that you can find in a lot of auto parts stores, and we have it online at fcpeuro.com. Now, looking at the top of it, you'll see a bunch of different markings on here stating the thickness of this ridge. Now, APR recommends 0.024 of an inch in gap between the electrode, and I'm going to be checking that using the tool. And just to reference, that is 0.024 inches. Now, moving this along, I'm going to move it until the resistance stops my electrode on the meter. And the center electrode and the ground electrode is giving me right about this measurement, which is pretty spot on. Now, if you have to open up or close it, there's gonna be two different ways to do that. And to open it, there's a little gap opener tool on here where we're going to be installing it and pulling upwards so we're not touching that center electrode. And then if we need to close the gap a little bit, we can take a hard table or something and lightly tap on that ground electrode to close that gap. Or you can use a specialty tool to screw a little fastening screw to tighten that gap. Usually I just use the light tapping method and just try not to be too hard on that ground electrode. Now, once I have the gap set for this plug, I'm going to set the gap for all of my plugs and then install them into the vehicle. So now that I have all of my spark plugs gapped, I'm going to use a little bit of the dielectric grease place it right on the porcelain and be sure not to get it on the actual electrical connector itself. This is just a insulator that is going to be in between the porcelain on the spark plug and the rubber boot. Now that I've applied the small amount of dielectric grease to my spark plug, I am going to take my spark plug socket, which is going to help me install these, and I'm going to thread it in by hand. So I'm going to place it down and then just get a couple threads so I make sure it has positive engagement. Now I'm going to do that with all of my spark plugs, and then I'm going to go back and snug them up and then have my final torquing. Now that we've snugged down all of our spark plugs, I'm going to take my spark plug socket and my 3/8 torque wrench set to 30 newton meters and torque all of my spark plugs. All right, now that we have all of our spark plugs torqued, I'm going to go grab my ignition coils and install them. One thing I want to mention about these APR ignition coils that's very nice is they do come pre-greased. So if you don't want to grease them before putting them in, don't worry, there's already going to be a little bit of grease in that boot already. Now, it doesn't matter what order you put these in, but we're just going to push this down and make sure it bottoms out. And I'm going to grab my next one and just continue until I have all of these ignition coils in place. Now, you're going to have to move the connectors a little bit to get them fully seated, and that's totally normal. See how I'm kind of pushing this one out of the way so I can slide it in and push it down. All right, now that I have all of those installed, I can take my bolts, my long bolt, and I can hand thread them in. You want to hand thread them in first because these threads are very sensitive, and if you cross thread it, it's not a good sign because you have to then repair the threads in the cylinder head, which we don't want to do. So always thread it in by hand so we're not going to damage those threads. Can be a little tricky. Sometimes you might have to wiggle it, move it around a little bit until you have a good couple threads engaged and I can pull up on it and it's not going to come back out. So I'm going to continue to do all that right here. You might have to move this harness off to the side a little bit. Once I have these all threaded in by hand, I'm gonna take my 10 millimeter and just snug them up. Be careful not to go too tight because we will have to torque these. Now that I have those ignition coil bolts threaded in, I'm gonna take my torque wrench set to 10 newton meters and slowly torque these bolts. Awesome. Now it's a very low torque setting, so be very careful. And if it feels weird and it feels like it's not torquing right, stop what you're doing. Now I'm going to take a 10 millimeter slim wrench. And the reason why we need a slim wrench is because we're going to have to counter hold the bolt. So put all your ground straps back on. These can be very fragile, so we want to make sure when we're torquing down the nut, these aren't going left or right and snapping this ground strap off, because if you snap that ground strap off, you're going to have to repair that harness, because you do need the ground strap on every ignition coil, or else that ignition coil will not function properly. Now I'm going to take the nuts that we have, again, thread them on by hand. These aren't lock nuts, so you can thread them all the way down. So naturally, the grounding strap when torquing is going to want to go to the right. So what I like to do is take my thin 10 millimeter, hold it a little bit to the left. So put a little bit of preload on it. Take my torque wrench that's also going to be set to 10 newton meters. And since it's going to shift a little bit, it'll keep it in the position that I want. Now I'm going to just repeat that on all of my ground straps. Now that I have all of my ignition coils bolted down and ground strap secured, I can start to push back down all the electrical connectors on the ignition coils. Now listen to that click. We're always going to want to hear that click because that verifies that it is actually snapped onto the connector. I also, once I hear the click, I like to get in the habit of trying to push the connector up, and that's just verifying that it has proper engagement. Now, this wire might come out of the grommet, so be sure all the wires are where they need to be. At this step, if you have the engine cover after the recall, we're gonna reinstall the engine cover here. Since we do not have an engine cover for this vehicle currently, I'm gonna skip that step. So that wraps up today's DIY video. If you've liked what you saw, be sure to hit that like button. If you have any questions about the procedures that I covered, be sure to drop it in the comment section below. And if you want to see more DIY videos like this on the Mk8 Golf, well, you're in luck because we have a ton coming on this channel. So be sure to hit that subscribe button. My name is Cole from FCP Euro. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.